Beloved, we are talking about the triumph of faith. The triumph of faith. Your faith being able to triumph over the enemy. Let us look specifically at what the scripture says. For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. Whatsoever. It didn't even say whosoever. You need to understand that, because whosoever is the person. Whatsoever is operational, because the idea can come from God. The unction can come from God. The notion can come from God. The revelation can come from God. So both me overcoming and my God-given idea overcoming is what the scripture is declaring. And it is based on one thing. It is born of God. So when you are seeking God to hear from God, take heart, because you are pursuing precious cargo, precious territory. That one wisdom from God, one revelation, it's enough to undo all that Satan has been able to accomplish all these years. So it calls for passion and determination to continue to seek God until I hear from him, until I'm born of him in that area, until I experience the certainty of the new birth in my own life. Because sometimes compromises filter it and you begin to waver and you begin to get confused and get disillusioned. And now you need the Holy Spirit to recalibrate you again and bring you back into certainty in Jesus' name. Are you plagued with unbelief and doubt? Then I'm prophesying to you. Are you perplexed and confused? Then I'm prophesying to you. Be born of God. Hallelujah. And if you're born of God, receive a fresh anointing. Receive a fresh mandate. Receive a fresh touch from God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Whatever is born of God, overcometh the world. I have to keep going, beloved. Listen to this. He says, it overcomes the world. So when something overcomes something, you know that there's a conflict. There's a challenge. It's a theater war there. Hallelujah. He didn't say he that is born of God overcometh the earth. He said it overcomes the world. What world? The system that Satan controls. This world with all its interconnectivities and their fraternities and their sororities and their cliques and their clans and their whatever organizations and the power brokers and the ombudsmen and on and on. The political organizations, all the executive esoteric clubs and on and on. All the money, all the politics, all their power, all of that. He said, he that is born of God overcomes this world. Ooh, what a revolution. What a strengthening that will cause the crippled to start walking. Your faith will begin to arise. You can start seeing that impossibility can be made possible. They have all the money. They have the media. They have all the power. They have all the jobs. They have everything. And yet the Bible says, if I am born of God, if what I'm saying is of God, if my plan is of God, it says, I will overcome this world controlled by Satan, controlled by the world, controlled by the power brokers, controlled by the political juggernauts, controlled by all these rich men. If I'm born of God, if what I'm saying is of God, doesn't that give you hope? Doesn't that awaken you? Doesn't that deliver you from helplessness? Because challenges in life can bring brokenness to you. You've been looking for a job for a year. And now you're so broken. You're almost begging for anybody to help if they could. If they can. And here comes the word of faith saying, if you're born of God, you overcome this world. There's no path for you to naturally get in. They have everything blocked. They have everything secluded and they dish it out to only those they favor. But it says if you're born of God, and if what you're saying is born of God, if what you're trying to do is born of God, he said, then you overcome. You overcome. You overcome this world. I know I can name all the organizations that come to mind, but you overcome. How do you overcome? Now listen to this. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Even our faith. Not just yours, but our faith. Glory to God. What is beyond us naturally? What is impossible to us? What we cannot touch or attain? What has even defeated us and had even overcome us in the past? He says our faith will overcome them. Our faith in God will overcome them. Why? A faith that stands will quicken the glory and the power of God to come from heaven to earth. I was reading Exodus, and God said to the children of Israel, now you have heard how I have come from heaven to speak to you. God descended on top of the mountain, and the mountain quaked, and it was smoke, and ooh, it was so scary, the people ran away. And God said, I spoke from heaven, and it looked like I'm there physically. But it's the glory of God that descended. That's the same way our faith activates the glory of God to come to earth to challenge these things that have dominated and controlled us all these years. Oh, may God awaken you. May God cause you to believe. May God strengthen you and me so that we can rise out of our brokenness and believe again and win. In Jesus' name. I love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.